Hi, this is Graham and I do hope everyone's having a great day. Well, welcome to today's video in which I'm going to describe a method called back button focus, and in particular for use with the FZ200. If you read camera magazines, you're probably aware of all the hype around the back button focus method which the DSLR shooters use to enable them to get better focus pictures. On the Canon camera, you'll notice there's a button called AF on, and you can actually program this to be the back button focus. If you're not aware of what back button focus is, it's a method by which we can naturally divorce the focus from the exposure mode. So when we half depress the shutter button, normally the camera focuses, and then when we fully depress that button, the camera will take the picture. When we use back button focus, we actually divorce the focus operation. So even when we set the focus using back button focus, when we press the shutter button, the camera doesn't reacquire focus. So it gives you a much more faster focusing system, and you don't get the variability that you sometimes get by using the same autofocus point in your shot. With the FZ200, if you look at the back of the camera, there's a button marked AF-AE lock. Now you would think that that would give you the facility to use as a back button focus if you set it for AF lock only. In some respects that does work, and it's quite an acceptable method for using a back button focus. However, there is a disadvantage by the fact that once you've acquired focus by pressing this button, if you want to acquire focus again, first of all you've got to press it to disable it, and then press it again to set the second focus. So you could actually lose a shot in that process. My method is using the manual focus method, and we use the side focus button to get us the single focus shot. To do that, you've got to be in the manual focus mode, so you need to slide the slide switch on the side of the camera to the manual focus position. When you do that, if you look on the LCD screen, you notice the MF icon has changed to yellow. That means that you have now control of the menu that will give you the facilities to set the size and position of the target for autofocus. You do that by just rotating the back control dial one click either way. When you do that, it brings up the menu for manual focus. If you act quickly within the first 1.5 seconds and press the menu set button, it takes you into that menu which allows you to set up the size and position of the focus target. To set the position, you use the four-way cursor dial, and that allows you to change the position anywhere within the screen. And if you want to change the size, you'll press the back control dial inwards, and that will allow you to toggle between a small and a slightly larger target area. It may be that you want to see the size and position of that target in the centre of the screen for your particular shot. Otherwise, if you have a subject which is off-centre but you want to keep that composition, move the target over onto your subject. When you've got the size and position of the target that you want, come out of that menu and go back into your shooting mode. Aim the camera at your subject with the target on the area that you want to be in focus, and then you'll press the side focus button. Now this actually forces the camera to do an automatic focus, even though you're in the manual focus mode. Once you've done that, the camera will lock focus. Now you can take the picture by using the shutter button, but it won't reacquire focus. It will use that focus point that you defined using that side button. So maybe you're at a zoo and you're shooting through bars. Once you've acquired the first focus, it doesn't matter if you slightly get any of the zoo bars in position, the camera won't focus on those bars. It will use the focus that you define with the side button. Or if you've got a bird in a tree and you've got the bird correctly focused, even if you catch a slight branch, the camera won't require focus and you'll get a better shot. So it does take out the variability of the focus you sometimes get with the autofocus methods. Hope you found that useful. I do have a photographic blog as well, and I'll put a link to that in the video description below. If you go to the homepage on the blog, you'll get the opportunity to subscribe to a newsletter, and the newsletter gives you access to pages which aren't normally viewable on the open browsing sessions. In there you'll find some more hints and tips. There's an editing section, there's a picture clinic, so if you've got pictures that you don't understand what's gone wrong, if you send me those images, I can make some comments and suggestions, and if possible I'll re-edit them for you. There's also some reader's gallery, and you'll actually see some of the beautiful pictures that have been shot using the FZ200 there. If you're a new viewer to this channel, please consider clicking that subscribe button. You'll then be notified when I do upload any new videos to this channel. Well, that's it for the video. Thanks very much for watching. Please do click that subscribe button and share it if you found it useful, and other viewers might also be interested in seeing this video as well. So until the next video, please take care. And bye for now.